Will not give in, says the soul to the skin. Now give me those animal thoughts you've been hiding. Rise from the bed, take the heart from the head, and ask if she really is broke. You're fine, she doesn't speak, but she was never broken. Always asleep, oh, and you thought he'd woken you. Don't cheat, says the soul, it's just meat on his bones. It smells sweet, but your conscience will eat at your innards. I'm calling from my cage. You'll regret that you locked me away. Good day, says the sun. Come hide away without moonlight. You're pale and undone, you must listen to me. This is what you are. It's not you that he'll see if you hold me far.
I didn't know initially what had happened because I had been calling him, trying to get a hold of him, and he's usually quite responsive, and he just wasn't answering my phone calls. And then I had found out on the news what had happened.
Police are investigating the brutal attack and murder of a street performer between the hours of 1 and 2 last night. Felix Birmingham had been performing late last night at Cowcaddon subway station when police believe the incident took place. Mr. Birmingham, 25, originally from Dundee, was believed to be a huge follower of famed Glasgow street performer Lucian Simon. Questions must now surely be asked at council level about the safety of street performers in Glasgow city centre. Mr. Lucian Simon was unavailable for comment. This is Danny Reid, Cowcaddon's underground station, Glasgow.
I called him so many times and he wasn't answering. So I went with the team to his flat, and he was there, and he, upon our arrival, he burst out and ran away and ran down the street. We followed him to a hairdresser's, and he was just like completely unresponsive when we asked if we were allowed to be there. So we just kept filming, and we just kept filming. And him having his hair cut was like him giving up on everything, like it was the end of everything. What I haven't explained is that I went to go see a psychologist. He had been seeing one. And I decided to ring him after the events that occurred in the evening class. And upon calling him, the psychologist had assumed that I knew more than I did, and went into great detail about how it was Lucien's fault that his father had died.
How present was your father?
My father died when I was 4.
Okay.
He was an engineer, and he was squished by a car.
And then his mother hated him because of it.
You ever felt love like that before in your life? Not even from your mother?
No.
Did you ever want some from your mother? No, you never did.
No.
Was she there? Was she there often?
No.
She could barely stand to look at Lucy. She treated him very badly. She beat him. She dragged him across the floor of his room. When putting him to bed, the feelings of loneliness would so overcome her that she would clutch him to her bosom so tightly, he would almost be smothered. Until she realized what she was doing and would release him. Eventually, with her own mind almost disintegrating, she abandoned him in the same empty workshop where his father had died. Surrounded by nothing but dead pigeons.
And he was stuck there for about 6 hours before he found a way out. But the psychologist went on to explain his methods in counseling him. The only way for him to overcome his anxiety and fear was to manifest it through another medium, which ended up for him becoming dance. And his main source of inspiration became the only thing that he was left with in his isolation, which became pigeons. It's a very odd combination of things, but when you have nothing left to hold on to, when you believe you are entirely responsible for every horrible thing that has happened in your life, and at your worst you take what you have, and at his worst, the best things that were with him were himself and these birds. And that became his next steps into recovery, I guess.
Have you seen him since the haircut?
Yeah, actually. I've another piece of footage that I haven't shown anyone. And I think I kept it because I just, I didn't really want to let go of it. We visited him in his office. Just like an empty shelf of like the person he was. Just, he's so vacant. He was just kind of like not the same person at all.
What are you working on?
Can we just finish this?
What are you doing here?
This is my work now. This is where I work. This is what I do now.
Are you happy?
Yeah, I'm very happy.
You look so tired.
I haven't been sleeping.
Why?
I feel very guilty. Is that what you want?
For what?
Is that the conclusion that you wanted to do all this?
It's not about you anymore.
Then why are you here?
Why would you feel guilty? You made something so beautiful, and then
whatever.
I don't know why.
Whatever you knew, it's gone. I'm done. I'm finished. I'm finished with all of this. I'm done with it. Okay? This is me now. This is me. This is me. I'm happy. I'm happy.
It's not your fault.
It's my fault.
It's not your fault.
It's my fault.
It's my fault. I told Felix to go out the night before his death, after the class we had. I encouraged Felix to go out and flash mob, and he did. I was the one that told him in the interview to just try it, and he fucking went out and he did it and he got killed. It's my fault, and he wouldn't have done it if I didn't tell him to do it. I'm sorry that I had to confront you in your office, but that's what happened. I'm so sorry.
You told him?
And I just needed that. So please, I just wanted to talk about it. I'm so sorry. Read you a poem, because I just feel like it's, like it's not, I can't explain anything properly, but I feel like this.
Is this by Lucien?
Yeah. It's a good homage to kind of, I guess, the artist that he was.
Like a prisoner flung into some deep, dry well. I have no knowledge of who I am or what awaits me. In my cell, I am quite alone. I open my lips to speak, and my voice echoes cheerlessly through this emptiness where no one listens. But you have not won. My body's beaten, but my heart beats on. These stubborn wings will leave the ground and soar up into the heights. Sometimes you have to be your own hero.
The last thoughts of a dying pigeon.
Something. Yeah. I don't really have much else.
That's so much in itself.
Oh, thank you.
I hope whatever you do with this, does better than whatever I thought I could possibly achieve out of it. So, thank you guys.
Thank you very much for sharing so much with us today. I know it must have been hard.
It's fine.
I'll be in contact.
Sure.
Yeah.
Bye.
So we've just finished speaking to Johnny Campbell.
would say that as long as there are pigeons,